Hey everyone, in today's video, I want to show you this editing software called iMovie, and it's the default editing software that ships with every Mac. So if you have a Mac, you should already have it. And I'm going to focus on the desktop version. They do have it for iPad and iPhone. I'll make separate videos about those later. And iMovie is a great editing app to get started with if you're new to editing. Once you get more advanced, the software that I use for editing is called Adobe Premiere Pro, and you could also try that out for free. And I have a tutorial to that as well if you want to test it out. It's a lot more advanced than iMovie, so if you just need it for basic editing, iMovie should do the trick. And in this video, I'll focus on the basics of iMovie and everything you need to know to get started. And if you're looking for more information on iMovie, I'm putting together a masterclass that's hours long to go through everything iMovie has to offer, so I'll put a link to that in the description as well when it's complete. And if it's your first time here, I make these type of videos every single day on this channel, so please consider subscribing. Let's jump in the computer and start using iMovie from scratch. iMovie should already be on your Mac. It does come with every Mac, but make sure you update to the latest version. I'm just in the App Store here, and I updated mine, and I'm gonna go ahead and press open. It's also in the application folder of your computer if you search for it. And after the welcome screen, this is the first screen where you wanna create a new project. So I'm gonna press plus here, and there's two options, movie and trailer. We wanna do a movie, so we have all the control here. Trailer is a template that lets you create a trailer. Very useful, but limited in everything that you could do with it. I'll make a separate video about this. Right now, let's go ahead and choose movie here. And then it's gonna bring you inside of iMovie. So let me show you around here for a second, then I'll show you the second step of the process, which is importing media. Down here is where all your editing is gonna take place, and this section over here is called a timeline. And over here is your viewer. You could view the different clips here, and over here is gonna be your media panel, where you could import media and then view them over here as well. Anytime if you press this project tab, it's gonna take you back to the page we came from. If you press this movie icon, it's just gonna make the movie screen full screen and collapse this section. And again, this is the import icon over here. And then we'll go and talk about these other options as we go through this project. So for step two, let's go ahead and press import and bring in some assets here. Now, assets are photos, videos, graphics, music. Those are all assets and media. I'm gonna press this option. And I organized everything into an external hard drive because I don't want to use my internal hard drive. So I bought an external hard drive and I put my footage from a card over here, my images over here, and everything is nice and organized in that hard drive. So in this case, let me go ahead and bring some footage over here. And I'm going to bring this drone shot and I'm going to shift select everything else you see over here. And I'm gonna press import selected. Again, make sure you get it from your card or wherever you're importing your footage from. Now, everything is gonna have this dial, meaning they're not ready to export yet, but you could start editing. That dial is also up here. If I press it, you could see that media is being imported, and until the importing is done, you can't actually export the project. That might take a little bit of time depending on your computer, but we don't have to worry about that. We could actually start editing right away. We'll just have to pay attention when we export that these are all actually complete. Okay, for step three, we're gonna start using our timeline down here and begin some editing. So to do that, let's go through some of these clips and how you would view the clips. They look like an image up here, but as you could see, as I scrub through them, I'm just having my mouse hover over them in and out here. You could see the video is showing over here. So if I select this and I just move my mouse through it, you could see the entire clip from the beginning to the end in the speed that I'm moving my mouse. And you could see the time over here, 1.6 minutes. That's how long the video is, a little bit over a minute and a half. Any video that you select, you could see this one's only 18 seconds, this one's 1.5 minutes, so on. But as I go through this, let's say this is a clip that I wanna bring in. Let me show you how to do that. First, we wanna select the endpoint where the clip starts. So in this case, I wanna show this as the endpoint right here, right where we take off from the sand. So as soon as I hover over here, I wanna press I. Now you see that endpoint, that little yellow section just jumped over here. And if I go over here to this point, I could press O for out. So I for in, O for out. And you could always grab this little handle and change the selection here as well. So if I wanted to do that instead of in and out, I can. And then this is my selection now. So in order to get this down to the sequence, I could drag and drop. I could press the little plus sign that appears in the corner of the clip here, or I could press E. The shortcut E will just bring it right down here. I could still make adjustment down here, and we'll go through that after we add a couple more clips. E basically adds it to the end of your timeline, and right now my timeline was blank, so it was in the beginning. But if I do it again, let's do it with another clip over here. Let's select this clip here. Again, I'm gonna go over here, press I, go a little bit further, press O, and then I'll press E. And just like that, I have a second clip added to my timeline. So you could go ahead and do this with your entire sequence. In again, O again for out, E again. So now I have three different clips on my sequence down here on my timeline. This is also known as a sequence, the timeline down here, now that I've started editing. Let me add a couple more clips here, then I'll show you how to trim them down here. So I'm gonna select my timeline here now, and I'm gonna press Command minus here to shrink it so you can see the whole timeline here. So I have these four clips. Next, I wanna show you changing the order of the clips. So if you wanted this clip to come before or after this clip, all you have to do is grab the one of the clips and then move it behind the other one, just like that. So you could change the order of clips just like that by picking up the clip and then bringing it to exactly where you want the clip to end up. Now, what if you didn't make a good judgment when you chose the endpoint and the outpoint of the clip over here? Well, you could trim the clip still while it's down here on your timeline. So let me show you how to do that next. The easiest way is if you want the endpoint to start earlier or later, you could just take it and then move it left or right. That will change the duration of the clip here. And as you can see, that time indicator shows how many seconds the clip is now, depending on how far you go. And when you let go, the edit's already done for you. So now, if I grab this little time indicator, this line here, and bring it over here on this previous clip and press spacebar for playing, you could see it just went to the next clip just like that. Now, let me show you how to split a clip into different clips. So I'm gonna bring my time indicator over to this clip. We're gonna focus on this. Let me press play, and let's see what happens at the end of this clip. Looks like I panned the drone quickly away from the shot. So I'll leave the time indicator here and I'll bring my line over here and I want to press Command B as in boy here, and that splits the clip into two clips. Now I could easily select the second part and press delete, and this is called a ripple delete. It means it takes the next clip and brings it and attaches it to this clip. So now if I go back to this previous clip, before the drone panned off, just like that, it cuts to the next shot. Now, let's assume we want to add music here. I haven't brought any music in, so I'm going to go up here and I'm going to go to the import option over here again. And now I have my footage, images, and logo I haven't brought in, but I want to bring in my music. So I'm going to select this song and I'm going to import that song here. And now it's up here. And again, I could either endpoint or outpoint, or I could drag the whole thing and bring it down here on a different track. You could see right underneath the video track now, I have an audio track. Again, I could go towards the end of this clip here, and then I could press Command B, and now it's two clips. I could select the second part and press delete. So now it's the same time as my video right here, and it ends at the same time as you could see at the end. And you could always stretch it to make it shorter or longer as you want to. And sometimes you want to change the audio levels on a clip. So if you change it, you see this line at 100%. If I click and drag it up, it becomes 400% if I go all the way up, and I can make it zero. So I could play around with this, but I don't want it to get to red. You see now it's getting to that red portion. Yellow is okay, but about 100, it looks like it's just about right. But if you have vocals here, narration, things like that, you might need to play with that audio level using this line over here. And another thing you might want to do with audio, especially music, is fade it in and out. So let me go to this end right here, and you see my arrow changed to these two little arrows here. And that's the little circle here that I could grab and drag in. And then there's one in the beginning too. You see it's right there. You can't grab the clip because that's going to change the size of the clip. You want to grab that circle here and bring it in. So now I fade in and I fade out. And if I move it, you could see how long the fade in and fade out is. So usually about a couple of seconds might be good for a music track here. So I'll go ahead and adjust this to be about 2 seconds or so. And now I have a nice fade in and fade out. So if I go back to the beginning of my timeline and press play, you could see that it's nicely fading in the music, and I could always increase that if I want to. Next, let me show you how to separate video and audio. These video files that I used here don't have any sound to them because they're from a drone. But here I have a different video. I'll bring it down here next to this one. And this one has audio and video on the same clip. You see how they're not on two separate tracks here. They're on the same video track. But maybe I want to make this more silent too and go with music. So in order to do that, I select this clip. And if I control click on it, there's an option that's called detach audio. If I press that, it takes that audio that was just on this blue part and makes it its own track. Now I could actually delete it so my video won't have any audio. I could always press Command Z if I make a mistake and bring something back. But in this case, if I deleted it, then I could maybe stretch the music to be a little bit longer. So now if I press play here, you could see that the video doesn't have my voiceover that was on previously. I could press Command Z multiple times to get it back if I want to. And now if I press play,
new selection.
My voiceover is right there with the video file. So I'm gonna press this and delete it. Now let's add some transitions. I actually do like these just straight cuts here. So if I press play, that was a straight cut. Going from one clip to another clip was a straight cut. But what if I wanna add a cool transition in between? Well, the best option is to come up here and go to the transitions tab. And you have a bunch of different options to choose from. Now, a lot of these are kind of cheesy, but the first four are very, very useful. Especially some of my favorites are cross blur or fade to black or white. So let me go ahead and drag this transition, and I could put it right in between two clips. And now if I go over here and press play, I have a really nice blur transition. Let's try the fade to black again, bring it between these two clips, put it right there, and then I'll press play here. And it faded to black. And if you wanted to make it longer, you could just double click it and you could change the duration to be maybe faster or slower. So right now it's 1 second, but 0.5 seconds maybe would be more appropriate here. So I'll press play again. That's a little bit better. Now let's add titles. So up here, I had my media tab. That's where all our assets were. You had your transition tab. And now you have title and background. Now you could use these together. For example, under background, I could choose one of these backgrounds, bring it down here. Let's say this was the title for the end of my movie here. I could go ahead and put it there as the background. And then I could go to title and then grab one of these texts here and then bring it on top. See, this time I'm putting it on top and not on the actual video file. And as you could see, if I double click it, I could change it. I could type in my text. I could change the font and everything else you could do to a text, like making a bold, changing the color. Everything is up here. And now if I go back over here and press play, you could see that title animation on top of that background. You could also grab a title and put it right on top of your video too. And as you could see in this case, if I press play, the text is right on top of my video as well. So you don't have to always put it on top of a background. And in fact, you could sometimes put it as a slate between two shots. So in order to do that, I'm gonna grab a text and put it right here in between the two shots. And then if I do that, now it's gonna go from one shot. I'm just gonna call this sunset. And now if I go over here and press play, it's gonna go from one shot to that slate. And then transition on to my other shot. So this is a really great way to use text as a slate in between different clips. And anytime you could select any of them and press delete. And another very useful option that I use all the time is this voiceover option. So click voiceover here and then give it access to microphone here. And then click this option over here next to the record. And here you want to choose a microphone that you have as an external microphone. I'm using a Yeti mic and I'll link it to the description. It sounds really nice and warm. So you don't want to use the internal mic. So I'm going to choose this one and then you'll get your audio. And as soon as you press record, it will record it right on the timeline. And now if you press this red dot right here, it's going to give you a quick countdown. And now everything I say is being recorded on this track. You could see this track going, and if I press spacebar to end it, it recorded my audio. Everything I say is being recorded. and it didn't even interfere with the music, so I put it on a different audio track here. Very useful option with voiceover, but again, it's because I'm using an external mic here. That's the reason why it sounds good, and I want to make sure mute project is turned on so it doesn't create a reverb and echo here when I record. And let me briefly show you this panel up here. I'm just going to go over it real quick to show you what's available. I covered this much more in depth in the advanced training. But over here, there's this one option. If you press this, it automatically tries to solve everything for you, including color, contrast, even sound. I'm going to press Command-Z. I'm not a big fan because it doesn't give you a lot of control. But over here, you have some other options like color balance, color correction, which is one of my favorites. You can make things more contrasty, add some saturation and some warmth to things just like that using this slider over here. Very useful. You have your crop option. You have things like Ken Burns effect, which is an animation on photos. Very useful. Fixing shaky images here is included. You have your volume control, which I already showed you down here. You have noise reduction here, which is useful if you shot things in the dark and they're kind of grainy. You have speed change. Again, very useful option where you could change things to be faster or slower than the way you shot them. And you have filters where you could just add a bunch of different filters from the selection over things just like this, so you don't have to manually change things. And you have eye for clip information here and when the clip was shot and what it was shot on. And finally, let's move on to exporting our finished video. So in order to export the video, we want to click this option over here, this up arrow, and you want to choose from one of these options. I usually recommend choosing file and exporting the file to your hard drive, and then you could use it to go anywhere else like YouTube. So press file. And if your importing is not done, this is not going to pop up here. So I know that could be an issue. So look over next to this pop-up over here to make sure the importing option is complete. And now let's go through some of these options. You could obviously title, description, and tag your movie file. But format, I obviously want video and audio. If it was voiceover, you could do audio only. Resolution, I could do 4K because I shot this in 4K. But in your case, 1080p might be the best bet. But typically between these two is what I choose. And then quality, this depends on your file size and where you're going with it. If you're going on YouTube, for example, high is great, but this is the file size that's gonna show you. If I go to ProRes, it's gonna be a much, much bigger file. This is 3 gigabytes compared to high was compressed for the web. Almost 10 times smaller here on high. So I usually leave this on high and I do compression, better quality if I'm not in a rush. And then I press next. And then I choose a destination here. Again, if I have that external hard drive, I'll just go directly to the external hard drive and press save. And then that's how you would export a video file from iMovie, and it's ready to be uploaded to YouTube or shared via email with your family if the file size is not too big. But I hope you found this video useful. Again, make sure you check out the more in-depth tutorial. That's hours of iMovie training if you want to take this to the next level. And you could always go to Adobe Premiere Pro training if you're really trying to make editing a more serious hobby or a profession. Please give this a thumbs up and subscribe for easy to follow tech tutorials, and I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.